So, yes, I've got another one in 2 weeks' time.
Oh, see, she knows what, she knows what to do. She does.
No, I have to ask you. I know I always make the J. McDonald reference. I'm so sorry, but she likes cruising. She belts out a few numbers on a cruise ship. Have you ever been asked to?
I don't belt out any numbers on a cruise ship, but I often get, when I'm in the dinner queue, you know, queuing up, and people will say, oh, I thought it was Jay McDonald when they hear me talking, you see. They might hear me behind me and I go, no, it's not her. It's not, I wish I could sing like her.
But she could get up and do poems for everyone. Oh, that's what you could do, Carol, isn't it? But also, in between the time since we last saw you, you've had two big events. One is that the big wedding.
The big wedding, the wedding of the year.
Yes.
Yes, it was fantastic.
Who got married?
My daughter, Jessica, got married to David. In July 27th in Ballinahinch, in a fabulous location. And we actually had such good weather that we had the ceremony outside.
And did you bake the cake?
No, because I couldn't transport it, because we had to go across in the Mustang. Michael's got a Mustang.
Oh, the Mustang's beautiful.
Well, Jessica wanted to get to go to the church, not the church, to go to the venue in the Mustang.
How cool is that? Totally rock and roll.
Well, it was cool, but it was a little bit of a worry for me because I didn't think she'd get the dress in the Mustang, but she did.
Oh, and bit of a squeeze.
And we couldn't have fit the cake in, so we couldn't get the cake in.
But did you do a poem for her?
Oh, yes, I did a poem, yes.
Aww, yes, I bet that was a weepy.
No, it wasn't a weepy. It was a funny. So it was more, I did a few jokes and then I told her, then I read the poem. So it went down very well.
Oh, how lovely.
I know.
You are going to do a poem for us this afternoon. Yes. And I believe that this one is really dedicated to all those parents whose offspring are heading away very shortly.
This is a weepy. This is the weepiest poem that I've ever written, actually. When I wrote it, the first time I read it back, I actually cried.
Really?
Yes. I wrote it as I'd been visiting Jessica. She now lives in the north of Ireland. And I'd been visiting and I came back and she hadn't been sort of in this new house long. And I thought, oh, I feel like I'm losing her. She's growing up. She's grown. She's gone. And I wrote this poem. And it did used to make me cry, but I'll be fine today. And it actually mentions her naughty Teddy is an absolute legend in his own bedtime. Everybody knows naughty Teddy. He did go to the wedding he is actually mentioned in the poem.
Real insight into Carol Ellis's family life.
It really is.
Really sweet.
This is a slightly abridged version because yes, I know the original has several verses, but what's it called?
It's called The Empty Nest, and I have actually, I'll only do the last few verses because it is quite a long poem, but if people want to read the full length poem, it's in a book called Food for Thought.
Wonderful. Carol, take it away when you're ready.
There we go. At the end of the day, all tucked up into bed, freshly washed hair on a warm, sleepy head. That old naughty Teddy, so worn and so battered, her constant companion, so loved and so tattered. Her magical childhood was filled with such joy. She was daring and bold, could outclimb any boy, artistic and sporty and smart and so funny. The pleasure she brought, you could not buy with money. You remember you dreamt of her as you were waking, but there in the real world, your heart was just breaking. No head on the pillow, no dolls on the floor. You walk past her bedroom and pause at the door. The house is so quiet, there's no tots and mums, no pram in the hallway, no more biscuit crumbs. What you wouldn't give for a swing on the grass, to see small fingerprints formed all over the glass. So cherish each moment, each joy and each worry. Enjoy every milestone, there's no need to hurry. Make sure that you treasure each moment they're young. There's no job more important than being a mum.
Oh, that is beautiful.
There are going